There were five meetings that we have detailed that show why the aid was released. There was a belief on the administration previously that Ukraine was one of the most corrupt countries in the world, that they had not engaged in sufficient reforms. And after a number of events with the vice president, with a bipartisan Senate delegation, there was a resolution of that aid. But this debate just lacks a certain sincerity. I heard earlier my friend from California, Mr. Swalwell, say, like, list out all these crimes. And so if I'm watching at home, I'm thinking, well, where are they in the impeachment? That is just a Democrat drive-by to go and list crimes that you don't allege and that you don't have evidence for. If there is ever a microcosm of how to consume this day and the importance of it with the American people, it's that they're naming crimes in debate that they don't even have in their impeachment resolution because they can't prove them, because there are no underlying facts. And then I hear my friend from New York, Mr. Jeffries, bring up Russia. Russia, the residue of impeachment theories passed and failed. How is debating about, how are we even here, debating about military aid, javelins, that President Trump delivered, that President Obama withheld? I hear them, you know, crying these alligator tears, clutching their pearls over this notion that, oh, well, oh, Trump didn't give this aid. We got to go impeach him for it. Where was all this concern about how to make the Ukraine great again when Obama was president? You want to know our substantive defense? It's four things. They've never changed. I think Mr. Jordan dreams of them in his sleep. Both President Trump and President Zelensky said there was no pressure. We saw the call transcript, and there's no conditionality. There was never awareness on the part of the Ukraine that there was a delay in aid. And the Ukraine got the aid without opening the investigation that seems to be so troubling to Democrats. Everything you're going to hear them say today can be pretty much categorized into three areas. First, it's either stuff people presumed and had no direct evidence of, kind of their water cooler theory of the case. Second, it's hearsay. Somebody told somebody else that created some concern about the president's conduct. Or it is reflective of a sincere policy disagreement about how to make the Ukraine great again. I mean, I heard all these folks come by that are part of the diplomatic corps, and they sure seem to believe that we ought to do everything for the Ukraine, but if the president disagrees with that, it is not impeachable conduct. Essentially, they're alleging a shakedown, but I think most Americans know that you cannot have a shakedown if the person allegedly being shook down doesn't even know about the shakedown. You have President Zelensky himself saying, I felt no pressure. And then, talk about bad timing. We got this Time article that comes out on the 10th of December, just a few days ago, because their theory of the case is, well, even if Zelensky didn't know there was pressure, there's this other guy, Yermak. And Yermak knew from Gordon Sondland that there was pressure. But the same day that they introduced their articles of impeachment, Yermak gives this interview with Time magazine, and he says, and I quote, Gordon and I were never alone together. We bumped into each other in the hallway next to the escalator as I was walking out. And I remember everything. It's fine with my memory. We talked about how well the meeting went. That is all we talked about. So here they are, with no crime, with no victim, with no witnesses, with no knowledge of any shakedown, and yet they proceed. To accept the Democrats' theory of the case, you got to believe that the Ukrainians are lying to us. You got to believe when they say there's no conditionality, no pressure, nothing wrong, that they're so weak and they're so dependent on the United States that we can't believe a word they say. Well, again, where were you during the Obama administration when this weak ally didn't get javelins that were then withheld? I support the Jordan Amendment because this Article 1, this abuse of power that they allege in the impeachment theory, is a total joke. They have to say abuse of power because they don't have evidence for obstruction. They have to say abuse of power because they have no evidence for bribery or treason. They have to say abuse of power because all those specific crimes that the gentleman from California named cannot be supported by the evidence. This is sort of the Rorschach inkblot test theory of impeachment, so that the country can stare at the inkblot and everybody can see what I guess they want to see. This notion of abuse of power is the lowest of low-energy impeachment theories. Heck, I don't know any political party that doesn't think when the other side's in the White House that they abuse power, they do too much. I got a lot of constituents that think Barack Obama abused his power, but you know what? We didn't do this to the country. We didn't put him through this nonsense and this impeachment. You all set the standard. We didn't set it. You said this would have to be bipartisan, compelling, and overwhelming. It ain't that, and this looks pretty bad. I yield back.